vote. If you liked the movie, talk about us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. The hashtag is diminuendomovie.com, or sorry, the hashtag is diminuendomovie. We're also diminuendomovie.com. If you hated the movie, please do not vote. Please talk about us on LinkedIn, LiveJournal, MySpace.
All right, everybody. I thought this was a very beautiful film, and there's one thing I want to talk about first. This is Richard Hatch's last film. He's a fantastic actor. I want to know what it's like to work with him. I think they do. So if you could tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I worked with Richard twice. I was involved in Cowboys and Angels, and I got to direct him in this. And it's not hyperbole to say that Richard was really just one of the finest people I ever met in every respect. And every place we've been with this movie, we met people who had done workshops with Richard or done acting lessons with Richard. And everybody comes and talks about what an amazing person he is. As an actor, it was great because I'm a very lazy director. And casting is 70% of your job. And so if you get people who are really good at it, you just kind of let them do their thing, and then maybe you step in and say, you're out of the light, move a little light. Okay, great. So that was my experience with most of the actors on this movie, Richard included. He was such a professional. I think the reason you guys wrote this for him is he never gotten a chance to do anything like this. He was always the hero, which is pretty boring. And we all just thought, we want to see Richard play the most knocked up man on the planet. And he killed it.
Definitely. So can you tell us a little bit about the inspiration behind this film?
So the base idea for this movie was, what if actors were replaced with robots? What would Hollywood be like? What would the film industry be like? And then that turned into, what if we made robots of dead actors? And we could have all of these celebrities from years gone by making movies today. And then that turned into, what if a director was hired to direct a robot? What would happen then? And then what if this director was hired to direct a robot of someone whom he loved? Maybe a dead girlfriend. And that's turned into that.
Very interesting. Something I hadn't seen before. And one specific thing that I really enjoyed about it was how you shot almost the real life version and then the acted out version with the robot. I thought that was really creative. And I wanted to see if you could talk a little bit about, you know, how you made those decisions to direct those two separate scenes. And especially you acted in both of those scenes. How did you distinguish performance with the director?
Well, it was really difficult for me. This was a super intimidating role because I was playing two characters. I was playing a robot, essentially, it was lifeless. And then I was playing one of the most bright, most just cheerful and wonderful, and she was just a muse.
And suicidal.
Characters, and so I really had to make sure I differentiated. So I spent like days trying to figure out the rules of the robot, but when you get on set, it just kind of goes away, and you just have to sort of figure out exactly how you're going to portray it, stuff that you don't even think about. Like, for instance, if you're in a room with a bunch of people and they're talking, who are you looking at, and what are the rules of that? So it was really, it was really intimidating, but it was one of the most fun roles that I ever had to play. So I'm very honored and very lucky to be able to play those roles, so thank you.
Did you want to comment on the directing?
So the thing that we've had people ask us, if this was like Memento, we put it all together in post, if this had all been shot to be linear at some point. It actually wasn't. It's actually written, intercut. So it's in the script. Now, we didn't necessarily stick to that in post, but it's written in the script. You know, here it is, it's actually Spain. Here it is, it's actually the movie. Here it is, it's actually Spain. Here it is, it's actually the movie. And the reason that we wanted to go through and do that is there have been so many movies built on flashbacks, and we kind of thought, what can we do that's different? Okay, well, we've got this director who's reliving these moments of his life. Let's intercut the real thing with the movie version and see if maybe that works. And then it actually turned into most of us, you know, it's our favorite parts of the movie. We're like, wow, that's really nice. Yeah, it actually works. That's great. So
I think that's great. So at this point, I'd like to open it up to questions from the audience. Does anybody have any questions? And forgive me, it's a little bit hard to see with the lights. Okay, so what's next, guys? Oh, I'm sorry.
I have a question. Then. So with regards to, there's a lot of genre actors in this movie, sort of outside of the genre, though, and I'm wondering, just with someone like Gigi and even Walter and stuff, what is that like to sort of step outside of the character actor role?
I was absolutely blown away. I think the solid with the script ever since I read it. Richard Hatch invited me to come on set and to read the script and work with these amazing people. He's a very dear friend, so I felt very blessed. And as soon as I read the script, I was in tears, I was laughing, I was so angry, it just took me to another place. And we all know working in the industry, it's so refreshing to read a script that's so amazing, like you've seen tonight. So thank you so much for having me.
Accepted the invitation to do this film for two reasons. One was I thought, wow, this script is so shaded, so nuanced in terms of how it has to be shot. It's a huge challenge to see if the audience can stay with it and be there through all of the convolutions that we see in terms of the flashbacks and what's real and what isn't real. What's really happening and what's in it. So I thought, this is a very interesting screenplay, one that I had not before had the pleasure of reading. And the second reason was exactly what you said. It was because it wasn't, you know, a space movie. You know, I got to play a character who was a not terribly nice guy, not terribly bad guy, but certainly not anything like I have been known for, and that was, I'm really grateful that our director had the courage to do that. It's not anything I'm ever asked to do, is, you know, space operas or something having to do with that. And here was a contemporary role in a contemporary, well, it's not really a contemporary film, but. I was just appealed to me the opportunity to do something different.
So what's next?
Well, we're all working on different things. I don't know what's good on the line. I theoretically am doing a horror movie in Africa. That's terrifying. And if not, then we have an idea for a $500,000 movie that is. I'm going to say this out loud. Nobody's going to believe me. It is, we actually think we have invented a genre. And we're going to do a movie that literally no one has ever done anything like it before.
Why not work?
I'm working on another low-budget indie drama about porn business.
I did the complete opposite of this film. It was a gem, the cartoon fan film, which just came out. Literally completely the opposite of this film. So that just came out, and I'm working on a couple other things. But nothing concrete yet, but hopefully.
Well, I could be under pitching something. I'd rather talk about this cast and our meeting later. It's absolutely wonderful. I was passing, I had deeply felt. So this is a very strong cast, and everybody involved should be really proud of what they've accomplished here. I applaud them all. Thank you for letting me part of it.
See, that's not fair, because I just wanted to talk about how your performances were this whole time. And I mean, you guys were amazing in this film. And I just thank you so much for lending your performances to this. Like, it was such an honor to be a part of this and work with all of you. So. All right, okay,
Freddie,
come on.
Okay. I don't have all that. I've got a small part in a Patty Jenkins miniseries called When Days Shall Darken, and I auditioned for a Jack in the Box commercial today.
I ate Jack in the Box today. We're traveling around the world with my beautiful brother on the Wonderland tour. We both sing, and we're squeezing in a little feature film after that, so everything's going to be
currently working on the Showtime show about Kidding right now, booking on September. So we'll see what happens. And thank you again, James and Sarah, for the opportunity. And I'm talking about you.
Thank you everyone for coming. Thank you so much.
Congratulations!
So thank you very much. Because I know we got to get out of here, there's another screening of another great movie, though. Thank you all for coming here.
Jason,
by the way, we're